You may recognize a change in your pet's behavior that could signify a change in their vision. They may bump into things, move more hesitantly, or struggle to find treats or toys. You may not notice a change in their behavior at all, which is why it's recommended that your pet has an eye check at least once a year, as part of their routine health check at your local daytime veterinary practice. One of the most common conditions that impairs vision is cataracts. What is a cataract? Like the lens in a camera, the lens in the eye focuses light so your pet should be able to see a crystal clear image. When a cataract develops, the lens turns cloudy and white, and your pet's vision becomes blurred. The size and position of the cataract determines whether and by how much vision is affected. If the cataract affects the whole lens, the eye will be blind. Imagine getting into your car after heavy snow and seeing nothing but white out of the windows. This is what your pet sees when an advanced cataract is present in both eyes. Although cataracts are often linked with old age, one of the most common conditions that cause cataracts in dogs is diabetes, which can affect dogs of any age. Other common causes in both dogs and cats are trauma, retinal problems, genetic predisposition, which can be passed down from parent to puppy or kitten, congenital factors when animals are born with cataracts, and sometimes no specific cause can be found. Treatment is generally not urgent unless the cataracts have developed rapidly, but regardless of the size, position, and progression of the cataract, referral to an ophthalmology specialist is always recommended to assess the best course of treatment. As well as reducing vision, cataracts cause inflammation inside the eye, called uveitis. Uveitis occurs in all eyes with cataracts, but can become an urgent condition in cases where cataracts develop quickly, like in diabetic dogs and after trauma to the eye. During your referral appointment, the ophthalmologist will do a detailed examination of your pet's eyes with different pieces of equipment. Your pet may be able to have surgery to remove the cataract or cataracts. However, suitability for surgery can depend on your pet's overall eye health and whether general anesthesia is considered safe for them. Routine blood tests and a blood pressure measurement might also be recommended before the surgery. Cataract removal surgery is called phacoemulsification. Phaco means lens, and emulsification means to break into small pieces. The technique used is the same as that used in human medicine. On the day of your pet's procedure, an ultrasound scan of the eye or eyes is performed to check for any problems behind the cataract or cataracts, and to take measurements for an artificial lens, which replaces the cloudy lens. In a small number of patients, an electroretinogram or ERG is performed to ensure that the retina is working. The retina is like the film in a camera and lies at the back of the eye, behind the lens. It receives light from the image and converts light energy into an electrical signal that travels along the optic nerve to the brain. Your pet will be fully anesthetized for their surgery, which lasts for 1 to 2 hours. While looking through an operating microscope, the surgeon makes a very small incision in the cornea, the windscreen of the eye. A probe is then inserted through the incision into the lens, where the cataract is formed. The probe vibrates like a jackhammer, breaking up the cataract into tiny pieces. This is the phacoemulsification part. The broken pieces are then sucked up by a different probe and removed from the eye, a bit like a miniature Hoover. The original lens is nearly always replaced with an artificial lens, which is implanted permanently into the eye. The incision is then sutured with dissolvable suture material, which is as thin as human hair. Monitoring eye pressure and applying frequent eye drops is a key part of recovery. And so your pet will spend 1 to 2 nights in the hospital following surgery. The ophthalmologist will assess your pet's eyes the morning after surgery to ensure they're healing well. The operated eye or eyes should be able to see straight away, and most are visual by the day after surgery. Some eyes, however, need a few days or weeks for their vision to settle fully. The first 2 weeks after surgery are critical for healing, and the ophthalmologist will prescribe a post-operative plan. Once home, your pet will continue an intensive schedule of eye drops and oral medications and must receive strict rest. They will also need to wear a buster collar at all times to prevent the affected eye or eyes from being rubbed. Your pet will need regular eye checks with the ophthalmologist at the referral hospital to make sure the eye or eyes are healing well after their surgery. If surgery is not an option for your pet, our ophthalmology team will usually prescribe eye drops long-term to help treat the inflammation or uveitis. And they will continue to monitor your pet's eyes for as long as required. Medical treatments won't make the cataracts disappear, but it will help to reduce the risk of complications that can develop without surgery. But as the cataracts develop, especially in both eyes, your pet will eventually become blind. Pets can adapt well even if they lose their sight. Dogs have a keen sense of smell that is incredibly acute compared to humans. And cats have one of the broadest ranges of hearing among mammals. These senses allow your pet to gather lots of information about their world, even though they've lost their sight, and they can continue to lead happy lives. For guidance or further information on your pet's eye health, please speak to your vet.